So in the animal science program at Great Oaks, when I first started, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do. I just knew I wanted to work with animals, and I was kind of going back and forth. I was really artistic, and it gave me the perfect segue. Grooming came out of it, and it was perfect balance of working with animals and creativity, so helped me find my place. I kind of felt like college really wasn't the route for me. I kind of had been pressured into college for a long time, and it just didn't seem, couldn't find somewhere where I really was interested, so Live Oaks for me was the perfect, it gave me a way to get started in a career without having to dedicate myself to college. My parents were really supportive. My mom had actually gone to a vocational school when she was in high school. She was a cosmetologist. So for her, she was excited to see me getting a trade and anything that would help find a career. And my dad had never really had any experience with a trade school. So he was kind of just, well, if it makes you happy, do what you want to do. But both my parents were really supportive, though a lot of my outside family members had all gone to college, and a lot of my aunts and uncles were all. For them, vocational school was kind of for the dropouts and the kids who weren't trying. So for me to say, okay, I'm gonna go to a vocational school and make a career out of it, they're kind of like, okay, we'll see. It was a matter of finding where I enjoyed myself and where I was happy. So I went into it knowing that I wanted to work with animals. And then from there, I found grooming, which for me, I found a passion immediately. It was just something I felt really strongly about, and we did state competition, and it really, everything just kind of amped me up. And then by the time I graduated, I have enough skills that I can just jump right into the field. Probably about 2 months before I graduated, I started really get on the search for a good groomer, a good quality salon that I wanted to spend time with. And a friend of mine had worked with Muddy Mutts, and they said, hey, we have a position opening up. If you're interested, just stop in, we'll do a quick interview. And then from there on out, it just went so perfect. Everything worked out. I came in for an interview and started low tier as a bather, and then slowly worked my way up. I did an apprenticeship under them and became a groomer after probably about 6 months. And then from there, the previous manager just kind of, something else came up and she had to bow out. So I was next in line and I got offered the position. Great Oaks gave me so many skills that I couldn't imagine getting anywhere else. Things like interacting with clients. And at Great Oaks, we had client interaction. They would bring their dogs in, and it was the perfect preparation for even just things like knowing which questions to ask, knowing just how to interact with clients versus even things with hands-on with the dogs, with knowing how to handle them, knowing the proper practices, compared to if I'm looking at a hiree and they come in with those kind of skills where they know what to do versus someone who's like, well, I owned a dog when I was younger. You know, it really sets apart. I mean, hands down, I'm gonna go with the kid who has experience. So it was the perfect road. Start off. The main difference from my home school was really just a hands-on experience. A lot of the stuff you're doing at the home school is in class, in books, and all that, and it is great in certain aspects, but having the lab differential is being able to get hands-on, being able to get that experience. Things you're not going to learn from a book, and you can't learn any way other than hands-on. Great Oaks really nailed it. You know, growing up, everyone always says, oh, you'll never work a day in your life if you love what you're doing. And it's cliche, but that's where I'm at. You know, every day I come to work, it's a different thing. There's something exciting. I get to work with animals. I get to make people happy. You know, we volunteer some of our time with the rescues around here, and just little things like that, just self-fulfilling things. You know, it makes you feel good at the end of the day.